guys, Mobbin here, back at you with a brand new video, and today I am on a server, and I'm going to do a server tour with these awesome guys. So, we have Ilmango.
Hello.
We have Ragu.
Hey.
And then we have Vince.
Hello.
And they're all a part of the SciCraft server. So, do you guys want to tell me what the SciCraft server is about?
Yeah, Ragu's the owner. You should have the owner.
Okay. So, the server is all about technical Minecraft and taking Minecraft to a scientific level, actually. So, we try to basically break the game whenever it's possible. And, yeah, well, we're having some fun screwing with Mojang, one could say.
Okay, I like it. So you guys,
the idea.
So you have a lot of redstone involved, a lot of redstone projects.
Redstone,
yeah, of course, redstone's in the utility.
Is a utility to achieve the goals, not really specialized in redstone contraptions like doors, more like in survival Minecraft farms and stuff.
Yes, so lots of farms, and I like that, and I know a lot of people like that. So today, we're going to be taking a tour of everything they have built, and the tour is going to be very long, so it's going to be broken up to a few episodes, because they have a lot of crazy things. So, let's jump into it. So, where are we right now?
We're in the middle of spawn. If you look around here, you'll see a giant square of ice with two rings of white stained glass, which mark the lazy chunks and the normally processing chunks.
Okay, so...
And of course, nice and flat with ice, so you're kind of quick. Looks kind of cool.
And you have farms.
We have a few farms here. An iron farm, a mushroom farm, and a bit out of the way, we've got even more.
Okay.
And we're standing on a tower right now with the ice stream at the spawn point where all the items that we get from the end up in this water stream and through a storage system we got here.
Okay, so in all the items that you put through the end portal will come right through here and then you guys sort them?
Exactly.
Yep.
Okay, so do you want to check this out down here then?
Yeah, let's go. Mm-hmm.
Okay, first we have a buffer storage here. Because we send a lot more items through at once from the Nether than our sorting system can handle it. So, yeah, this is the buffer storage and it reduces the speed down to hopper speed, basically.
Okay. Very cool.
So everything gets shut out by this one dropper down here.
Okay, but it doesn't ever back up. So you're making sure the items are always in a hopper or chest.
Yeah, so they don't despawn.
Yeah.
There are a hopper minecarts at the top that can pick it up, so no item would despawn.
Okay.
Yeah, they can pick up 40 items per second, so that's the threshold for this system, and then they are further transported with the single hopper with 2.5 items per second, because the filter system is slower than what we send through from the end.
Okay, so then the items go through the dropper, and then they go and get sorted, right?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Since the spawn chunks are always loaded, the speed isn't really an issue for us.
Okay. Makes sense.
That also means that everything gets processed and doesn't back up completely. And I think to get down, it's faster to just use an ender pearl.
Okay.
This is close to the build limit.
Okay, and now we're down here. Where did everybody go?
You'll have to walk around.
Okay, we went. Okay. Ooh, this looks cool. Okay, here we go. So this is where the items get sorted into all these chests.
Yep. So of course we don't send everything, or we don't sort every item here. Because all these chests and especially the hoppers behind are always loaded. So we want to keep performance up a bit. But yeah, just everything we produce in the end, so to speak, gets sent over here.
So many pistons.
Yeah, because we have our wood and stone farm that is automatic and powered by wizards in the end. Because we use the bedrock from the end portal as a safe wizard cage, we craft all the stone and wood related stuff in the end, like the pistons and repeaters need a lot of stone. And
okay.
It's just easier to bring over iron to the end and craft it there.
Okay, that definitely makes sense. And
then also some other items that we produce in the end, but I guess we'll see that later.
Yeah, and so do you guys plan on stacking this up a few more layers, or is this all you're going to be sorting here?
No, because the inventory of chests creates lag, it's a stress on the server, and this is as big as we wanted.
Okay.
So we have a separate storage, but this is just for the bulk storage. We really have more than 4 or 5 double chests.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
So in general, everything's as clean as possible in the spawn chunks, but yeah, since the stuff comes from the end, we have to store it somewhere. We had to build it here.
Okay, very cool, very cool. And then, so this is your storage for bulk storage.
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
And pretty much.
So now...
We have a wool farm there, so yeah, that stuff.
So the wool is on top here.
Okay, yeah.
And yeah, here on the sides, we actually have 2 more things that we store, because they're actually produced at spawn, which is iron.
Okay.
So obviously from the iron farm.
Yeah.
But here we just store the blocks.
Yeah, iron farm also produces when nobody's on the server. That's one specialty about iron farms.
Really, they work when no one's logged on?
Yep.
Yeah.
As long as they're in the spawn chunks?
Yes.
Very cool. I didn't know that.
Spawn chunks, and you need to do some trickery, but that's not too difficult.
Okay, that's interesting. I didn't know that. That's very cool, actually.
And then something that actually requires a player to be around spawn, because it's related to mob spawning, that's a mushroom farm. And we store all the beef here.
Ah, you got so much beef. And
oh, yeah.
Leather, and so do you guys do you split up, like, do you have it all raw beef and you cook half of it, or
half of the farm produces raw beef and the other half is steak?
Okay, I see what you're saying, but yeah. So what do you want to check out next? What are we gonna check out next?
I guess we should go to the iron farm. It's right in front of the tower.
Mm-hmm.
I do like the iron golems holding up the iron farm.
Yeah.
But this is iron farm. It's different. I've never seen one designed like this.
Yeah. So it's actually a design I made specifically for the server.
Okay. So you guys created it yourselves.
Yep. Yeah. It took me like 1.5 weeks or so. So that was relatively fast for an iron farm.
Yeah, how many villages does it have?
So that one can go up to 256 villages.
Wow.
But at the moment we're only running at a fraction of the performance, just because the game code is a bit messy with a lot of villages, and it tends to lag. So since we're basically all our storage is full, we just keep it at 32 villages and then stop the rebuilding process.
Okay.
But of course it can rebuild automatically, so if we need more iron, we just have to remove 2 redstone blocks that block it at some point, press the reset button, and a few hours later it's running at full capacity.
Okay, so, quick question.
Yeah, at full capacity it would produce 10,000 ingots power.
Yep, roughly.
So my question is, do you, I know it's in the spawn chunks, so why do you need it to, like, reset? If it's always going to be loaded?
Sometimes loading can just fail.
Yeah, there's a rare chance that it fills.
Really?
So, yeah. Just to make sure, it happens with the Iron Titan and stuff. We don't want to replace all those doors again and again and again and again. So.
Okay, so you just put like a safety net.
Yeah, also, we're just lazy to build it manually, and building it in a more technical way is just more fun.
Okay, I see.
Yeah.
Okay.
Pressing the button is more fun than placing doors.
Dang, let's see. I can't get up here. This elevator doesn't like me.
I think it's the ping.
Sometimes it doesn't work, yeah.
Yeah,
I get so close.
On a European server, it's always an issue of the ping.
Okay,
yeah.
I think I got this. I got this. Wait, here we go.
Nope.
I lost my enderpearl. Oh god. No, not working. Okay, I can't go up there. Looks cool.
Aww.
Oh, it worked.
That's just help out in this case.
Yeah.
So the elevator normally works, but
but I'm so far away.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is looks very complicated.
It actually isn't, because this is the entire brain more or less of the farm.
It's so complicated, Regu. It's still
complicated. It's not that good. I mean, I'm not really good at compacting redstone, so it's a bit messy, but it's really just some logic to get the reset going. And once the signals have gone through this part, it's just a few clocks running.
Okay.
Clocks. And that's doing almost everything.
Okay, so then this, I see, and then it gets slowly gets rebuilt, and then they spawn in the redstone blocks, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
So that's a concept that I think the first one who published it was Panda. So Panda 4994.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And it's just a bit more efficient than having the usual two spawn layers.
Yeah. Okay, so I assume you guys now have unlimited iron.
Yep.
More than unlimited.
More than unlimited.
Actually, at some points when we didn't have to farm for too long, we were in need of quite some iron because we made several projects and used iron as the main building block. Then it actually went a bit short, but yeah.
Yeah, it's our own fault.
Yeah. Yeah, so I guess we'll hop down to the mushroom farm.
Okay, yeah. I like the glass.
Yeah, and the glass is actually something important.
Okay.
Well, at least that it's not a solid block. Because this farm is fairly productive for its size.
Yeah, it looks really small. Like, how many layers is it?
It's two spawn layers.
Just two?
Yep.
I look at your other farms, and it seems like you guys use more than two spawn layers.
No, in this case, we had to limit it to two, because adding more spawn layers doesn't add that much to the efficiency. In fact, well, it wouldn't really decrease it, it would quickly saturate.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the max efficiency we can get for spawn layer.
So with it being only built this low and no other solid blocks, that just helps the efficiency?
Exactly.
Yes. So basically, the spawn attempts are spread out in what is called subchunks. And by having all the farm in just in the lowest subchunks, all the spawn attempts happen just in the lowest subchunks. So if you would have solid blocks at Y15 or 16, for example, that would reduce the efficiency of the farm by 50%, because then also the game attempts to spawn mobs at the second subchunk.
Okay.
Yep.
And I see you guys have... So you want to explain to me how this farm works?
It's a flush design, but instead of flushing a complete layer, we use tripwire to disable one piston so one strip of water flows out, flush off any mushroom cows that spawn there.
Okay.
And for
so
the people,
I can make a dummy so if it would stand in here, then.
Okay, other cows could still spawn.
It just reduces the number of updates.
Mm-hmm.
The spawning isn't actually an issue because they only spawn every 20 seconds.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's just game mechanics. So there's nothing you can do about it. Every 400 ticks, the game attempts to spawn passive mobs. And yeah. So that's why we also have some time to get rid of them. So we don't need some piston pushers or whatever, but flushing them is fast enough.
And then
as long as we kill them in 20 seconds, the raids won't suffer.
And then why do you have purple glass here?
That's actually a slight oddity. So most of this, of course, a mushroom biome, but this little corner here is actually a plains biome, and so we had to make it spawn-proof.
Oh, okay, that makes sense.
So that's why there are a few blocks in glass.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, it's not even because other peaceful mobs could spawn there, because it's mycelium, so no chickens
or slime chunk.
Yeah, the reason we put glass there is because it's a slime chunk, and normally in mushroom biomes, no hostile mobs spawn, but just because that's a slime chunk and it's not a mushroom biome anymore, slimes could spawn in there and constantly activate the tripwire and just be annoying, pretty much.
Okay, so they fall down here, and then what do the gas do?
Most of the cows burn from the lava. But some of them get back into the water and would stay on this white piece of carpet there. And
yeah,
never move again. So they wouldn't be killed, and slowly but surely the mob cap would be filled with some carpet, and yeah, then the farm would break. So the gas just pushed the cows back into the water, what pushes them back into the lava a second time, and yeah, that kills them finally.
Okay, yeah,
but
I think
the gas are just backup.
Okay, so okay, yeah, because I think when I first came down here, I saw a cow just sitting there, and then the gas came and pushed it into the lava.
Yep.
Exactly.
Okay.
That's the thing. So normally they die from
just by flowing themselves.
Any interference, but yeah.
Okay, here's a cow right now. Yep. Okay, so those two are burning, but some of them might get stuck.
Yeah, it's like a 5% chance that a cow survives.
Okay. And then this is just redstone stuff to control the gas.
Yeah, that's actually important.
There's also trouble with the gas, which we didn't notice at the beginning. The pistons that would lower down to let the water flush somehow damaged the gas. And yeah, we had this running for 2 hours and our gas were gone.
Okay. With these pistons, right?
Yeah, I really don't understand why this happens. It shouldn't happen because a piston is a transparent block. And yeah, it shouldn't harm a gas, but it does. And just in the exact same moment when the piston goes down and the gas is on it, so the chance is quite low. And because gas get damaged, we have to heal them. So we have a brewing system here, and there's a counter here. So every sixth time a gas comes by, he gets a splash potion in his face to heal him.
Okay. That makes sense why the potion stuff's here. So you just brew a bunch of healing potions. That makes sense. And you have how many gas?
Just two lanes.
Just two? Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So that's why we produce steak, and we also have two other lanes where we have a system where the cows die reliably by the lava. So this is here.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, because the cow doesn't die from from fire damage, but from lava damage, it does drop raw beef.
Okay, so that's why you have the raw beef in the...
Yeah.
And so we couldn't get the compromise, like killing them reliably and making sure they die from fire within this small space we have here, because, well, we wanted to stay in the lowest subtrunk, of course.
Mm-hmm.
So that was a bit of the difficulty, and yes. It does take quite some time to travel. We only made two lanes for steak, and the other ones we left for raw beef.
It's probably a bug that they don't drop steak from lava damage.
It's on the bug tracker, yeah.
Okay, so we've seen your iron farm, so you have unlimited iron, and now you have unlimited food.
And leather.
What else do we need?
Well, there's a lot more. Of course you need all sorts of mob drops, not just steak, right?
Yeah, you need all the mob drops, especially rotten flesh. I think rotten flesh is the most important one out of all of them.
Yeah, exactly.
To get some mob drops in a reasonable way, we should still prepare something. And I think that's what we should go to next.
Okay, yeah, that sounds good. And this is all still in the spawn chunks?
It's not in the spawn chunks. I mean, in general, you want to keep the spawn chunks empty.
It's half in the spawn chunks, but because there's no, like, there are no hoppers and chests and stuff, so it's not really laggy.
Ragu, behind you. Behind you, Ragu.
Two evil creatures.
They shouldn't. Oh no, yeah, they can spawn. Okay. Yeah, so I guess we just use nether, because it's a bit easier to get in.
Okay.
Or you see it over there.
Okay, very cool. I'm liking it so far. I hope you guys watching are enjoying it so far. There's a lot of cool stuff and a lot more to see.
Oh, we should turn off the farm. Vince, can you briefly stay behind?
I'll go back,
just to make sure it's not breaking. Yeah, so in general, we always have some problems with trunk unloading and some bugs in the game. Yeah, so there are two things we have to pay attention to.
Okay.
Then, where's the thing? Ah, over here. I keep screwing up the orientation here as well, but...
Okay, so to the nether warp farm.
Yep.
So
I just made a small farm for that. Because why not?
Yeah. Okay. This is not small. Oh my god.
It's relatively small for our scales.
Oh my god, this is huge. I like the pyramid. It's like almost like trippy because it's like black
yeah.
and then white, black and then white. But, geez, okay, I was thinking when you said small, like maybe just like two or three rows of this. Not this much. So I assume you guys have a... Okay, so how does this work?
Mango, it's your farm.
Okay. Yeah, so... You would sit in a minecart here, and yeah.
Okay.
Every time
okay.
you come into a lane, you go over this detector rail here. That pushes the soul sand back and back and forth. So the just with a short pulse, so the nether wards that drop there would remain behind on the nether ward on the soul sand.
Mm-hmm.
And then if you pass by, you would pick up the nether wards that lie on the soul sand. And if it would just hold down your right mouse button and plant new nether ward.
Okay, so
and
you have to AFK here.
You have to AFK here, yeah.
Okay.
And the nether wards that you don't pick up would be later picked up by a hopper minecart that is traveling under the soul sand.
Yep, actually over here you can see one. It's ready.
Okay.
So whenever you finish a lane, like at the beginning of a lane, you trigger the pistons. Oops. and when you finish a lane, you trigger the minecart. Hopper minecart.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
And this farm is so huge because it takes some time for the nether wards to grow back. So if it would be smaller and you would go back to the same lane every 3 minutes, no nether ward would have been grown. So you either stop and do nothing, or you make it as big as necessary. So you would constantly plant new nether wards.
This is huge. So now we have iron, we have food, and now we have lots of nether warts. You guys are crazy.
Oh, yeah. And we'll need them later on.
Okay, so later we're gonna see why this is needed.
Yep.
Okay.
Well, maybe not in mass quantity, but still in rather
mm-hmm.
huge quantities.
And farming nether warts is annoying, so really happy to have an AFK solution.
Yeah, the soul sand is really annoying to walk on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I definitely understand your pain. Okay.
But we are already talking about mob drops, so the majority of it can be solved here.
Okay, let's see. There we go.
We're here. And we have to get out of the back room.
Okay. So this is... Oops. This is your mob farm.
Well, it's just a small storage room on top here.
Okay, so
if you look down, you can get an idea of the size.
Oh, is this the roof?
So what you can see there is the roof and the lighting system to turn it off.
Okay, wow.
At the moment, it's actually turned off.
Wow.
And, well, if we turn it on, you will experience some lag because of all the light updates.
Uh-huh.
So let's hope we don't crash anything.
Okay, I see it. So do you turn it off with a little bit of a delay so they don't all update at once?
Yes. There's a
yes.
really small
yeah.
amount of delay, but it still causes a lot of lag.
That's 4,000 redstone lamps turning off and all the light updates that go along with it.
Okay,
yep.
Yeah. I slowly see
I
it's
think
almost
there's
there.
Even like a 10% chance to crash the server.
Oh, wow.
But
on.
We don't turn it on and off too often, so it's not a big issue.
Mm-hmm. And then this is where it all gets stored. Oh my god.
Yep.
Oh, mango crashed, I think.
No, I just have to restart my game, that helps.
Oh, yeah. now it's getting better.
Yep, I don't think
so
I...
So for me, some lamps are still turned on, but that's just a visual glitch.
Oh yeah, I see it. No, okay. None of mine are turned on. They all are turning off. Actually, I don't know. That redstone looks still on, but I guess it's a visual glitch.
It's not, yeah. Because there is so much going on. It's kind of like the flying machines. If they are too busy processing everything, everything in the distance doesn't get updated. So if you relog now, you would see that all the lamps are off. But because the game tries to give you some FPS while you're doing this stuff, they forget to redo that stuff eventually.
Okay,
and
so
you can actually see the first drops coming in.
Oh wow, that is, oh my god, that's so nice. See, like, do you guys get like satisfaction out of that? Like, you built this whole farm and then you just see drops flowing in like that.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's very cool. Oh, and then I could see that you're getting some witch drops as well, just because they spawn randomly sometimes.
Yeah.
The farm is actually that big that if you would have four times the results of this farm, you would get as much witch drops as you'd normally get from a witch hunt.
Wow.
Yeah, so it's a quarter of a witch hunt, the output. Yeah.
That's pretty cool. And then you have storage for all the drops you get. Are all these chests
for nothing?
No, we're just to unlock clerics.
Yeah, to unlock them, but not to trade because it's such a thing.
Wait,
then
so if
gunpowder for TNT goodness and potions.
So my question is, are all these chests? If all these chests are full, then where does the stuff go?
Gets destroyed.
Cactus.
Cactus destroy it.
Yeah. So, like on the roof of the storage room here, or storage cloud. There's just a water stream going once around the entire storage, and at the end it goes into a cactus.
Okay. Yeah, this rotten flesh, it's nice. It's so powerful. So many things you could do with it.
Yeah, actually we mostly need it for the gunpowder and the bones.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Arrows? Oh, now there's that.
No, even less than rotten flesh.
No, not even in the in the next update there's like tipped arrows now and stuff.
Yeah, but once you've got 50 double chests of arrow, you're
infinity.
And infinity, of course.
Yep.
Wow, that's crazy. It's a very cool mob farm. I like it.
There's a reason why we always have the highest enchants on our gear. Well, after some time it's obvious that you want to go for the highest levels.
Mm-hmm.
But I think, should we head down and have a look at the farm?
Yeah, we can make our way down.
Can I turn it off?
That would lag again a bit, but I guess we can just go down so we can see it in action.
Yeah, sure. Oh yeah, that's pretty cool.
Even though it's a bit hard on the rendering.
Mm-hmm. Dang, they just flow non-stop.
Yeah, it's 110,000 items per hour.
110,000, dang.
Around here we can see the one killing floor. So the spawn floor is above and it's just a piston pusher set up with glass blocks in front of the pistons. And activated by tripwire.
Wait, is there, how many layers is there?
It's only two layers.
Okay.
And that's the same reason why we have two killing floors here. So this is the first one and there's another one below.
Okay.
So the reason why we only have two spawn layers is because of the falling time. So this farm basically always runs at the mob cap, which is why it's so huge. So we run mob cap. At the same time, we want to keep the average lifetime of the mobs as low as possible. And that means we have to kill them as quickly as possible.
Mm-hmm.
And since we kill them by fall damage, we want to keep the distance they have to fall as low as possible.
Okay.
So kill almost all the mobs here at the first killing layer. And of course we only have two spawn layers, so they don't have an additional distance to fall.
Mm-hmm.
And the only mobs that survive right here are mobs that have armor. But of course we want to get rid of them as well, so they can actually drop through after they took some damage.
Also the witches.
Oh yeah, witches also do a bit more damage. And then they land on the second killing layer down here, and basically everything dies down here.
Except chicken jockeys.
Yeah, and they fall down even further into the item collection, but the item collection is just far enough away from the player on top, so they would actually despawn.
Okay, I see what you're saying.
so we also get rid of them in some way. And in case some of them stay behind, of course, when we plant down here, something will stay behind. We also have staff updates to get rid of
the
some
mobs. Chicken jockeys could pick up items from other mobs that die and won't despawn, so we have some lava as a final backup.
Yeah, even though they wouldn't bump to the mob cap anymore, they would create a lot of lag and pile up, so yeah, we get rid of them as well.
Very, very cool. Oops.
Oh, and sometimes also other mobs make it through, but it's fairly rare.
They'll let this die. Okay.
Yep.
It's very cool and very big. So now you guys have a lot of things, a lot of items, but
oh, yeah.
There's still a lot more.
Can you turn it off?
I'll turn them off from off.
Okay. Yes, every now and then some mobs come down here. But we have another thing around here, and that's where our nether wards are actually needed.
Oh, okay.
So I suggest we go to the next place.
Okay. So, how are we going to do that? It's the best way.
We can... Well, instead of climbing up, we can just jump down.
Yeah, I'm just going to the water.
So just try to land somewhere over here.
Okay. Okay, wait. I gotta turn down my, hostile creatures. Yeah. Very loud.
Yep.
Okay, so now we're at the So this is something completely different than the mob farm?
It's still a mob farm.
It's a different type of mob?
It's a guardian farm, as you might be able to see from the floor here already, and maybe the height.
Okay.
Are surrounded by ocean.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we have a little room here just to store our tools. And that's mostly because we enchant and prepare them here. Since we actually have a decent XP mode for our guardian farm.
Okay, so what do you so you use the Guardian Farm for XP?
Yep, of course for some drops, but they're not really that important.
Mm-hmm.
And if we come over here, we actually have two modes, so we can of course set it to an automatic mode, which would mean the outer part of the Ocean Monument area would get turned on. So we have water there, guardians fall down, die directly. Upper minecarts collect the drops, and we get the drops.
Mm-hmm.
But the center of the monument we actually reserved for manual farm, and I think we should demonstrate it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. We just had someone else joining, so maybe the mob cap is filled.
Wait. Question. So you use the nether wards to for this part right here?
Oh yeah.
To make instant damage potions to kill the. The guardians to get XP and.
Oh, okay, so.
And the rare drops, of course.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the most important point. Also, is you wanted to get the rare drops. And, yeah, so basically you can AFK because you just have to aim at one place. You get the potions from this dropper.
Okay,
you just
so.
Go through the gap up here. On the right hand side, you can see where you have to aim.
Yeah, so.
And
you use that free screen.
Damage lasts. So the time when you get the potion is made in such a way that you don't hit ghasts at any point.
Okay. Let's see.
So it's after the ghast again, you can just throw it on the right hand side to see where you have to aim.
Yeah.
It's 90/50.
So I should throw it after the gas bounce back and then leave.
Yeah. I mean
I'll just keep right clicking, basically.
Okay. I have a
That was bad timing.
Yeah, sorry. I don't. I have like I have so many. I have like 8 instant damage potions on me.
No problem.
Yeah.
Watch out, you're
gonna
get shot. Yeah. Oh god,
I'm dying. Guardians can see you at some points, but not when you're standing in front of the thingy here. So maybe I can just give it a quick demonstration.
So if you're standing right there, they can't see you.
In the timing.
Okay.
So now I'm in the right timing. I just hold on right click and I could just go AFK. and I'll get a ton of levels, a ton of rare drops.
Okay, so the use gas again, and they push the guardians into this place right
exactly.
here.
So we have two layers of gas, some that push them like into this trench here, and then two that come from the left and the right, pushed into the killing chamber.
Okay, and you use this for XP, so you could do a lot of enchanting?
Exactly.
Well, not really. You can call it enchanting, but we only use enchanted books we get from villagers, so we combine books on our tools, not even actually enchanting.
Okay.
Yeah, I think this is pretty much one of the fastest XP farms I've ever seen.
Do guardians drop more XP than other mobs, or...?
They drop better XP orbs, so you're... Because generally, if you go for really fast XP farms, you're limited to the size of the XP orbs, because they don't stack like items do.
Mm-hmm.
That's why blaze farms could potentially be better than, I don't know, an enderman farm, because endermen just drop the same as skeletons or zombies. And guardians and blazes drop a lot more, so it's... And guardians are, well, they spawn in a huge bounding box, so you get a lot of XP and mobs.
Mm-hmm. Oh wait, and then you guys also have a, mushroom farm.
Yeah, because you need them for the fermented spider eyes. For
okay.
The damage potions.
Oh wow, this is big.
Yeah, because mushrooms grow so slowly.
Yeah, okay.
And this just activates every few minutes. Flushes everything out. So in the middle part here, some mushrooms are planted, which act as seeds.
Mm-hmm.
And then they grow to the side here.
Yeah, they spread.
So. Exactly.
Yeah.
And
we use the pot soil here, because on pot soil they grow regardless of the light level.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And then guys got a cactus farm here? Any...
Yeah. We obviously wanted to put some squid in here just to have the more cap for squid tilt, but we figured it isn't really required and it doesn't have a significant influence on the farm, so we just used the space.
Okay.
Yeah, because we spend a lot of time here and we didn't have a cactus farm yet, so yeah. No real reason that it's here.
Okay. So now you have a lot of XP to do enchanting, or you know, books with anvils. Very cool. You brew potions automatically. Okay. Well, really cool. Lots of XP. Very nice. Very fast. Is that everything at spawn?
This isn't really spawn anymore. It's close to spawn.
Yeah, it's close to spawn, but I think that's the last thing close to spawn, yeah.
Yep, everything else is slightly farther away.
Oh, we also have a small sugarcane farm here. To get the sugar for the fermented spider eyes.
Oh, okay. You want to show me that really quick? I think we'll take a look at that and then call this an episode.
Okay. It's at the back. Oh yeah, this is also a transport line, because we buy the books 1,000 blocks away from here and transport them over with this dropper line.
The books?
Books for the tools.
Wait, they travel through all these droppers?
Yes.
Yep.
Do they
So the repeaters load chunks that aren't near the player, and that's how you could transport a few items over bigger distances.
Okay, and then how does it activate, though? The repeater?
Yeah, yep. There's a clock. You put the items in a chest at the place where we get the books.
Mm-hmm.
And this is also loaded, is chunk loaded from the spawn chunks. And so it wouldn't unload. And then the signal travels through all the unloaded chunks and the books are transported here, so you don't have to bring over that many non-stackable items on your own.
Very cool. Very cool.
And then the sugarcane farm is just a small farm at the end here.
Okay.
It's really satisfying.
Yeah, we couldn't show it in action. So there's a daylight sensor at the top. It would activate once every 20 minutes. And the minecart, the hopper minecart, would activate those double piston extenders, which pushes the sugarcane down. And then after it passed the detector rails on top, it would pick up the sugarcane that drops on the dirt, and then there's a chest.
Okay. So it's just simple enough, so you get enough sugarcane you need for sugar.
Yes.
Yep.
Okay. Well,
We also get some sugar from the witch drops, but it's not really enough, also. At least we use the gunpowder from the mob farm at the top, so for the brewing, we use that. So there's a hopper line leading down from the mob farm at the top that supplies the brewing system with gunpowder.
Okay. Yeah, well, that's actually smart, since you have so much gunpowder. But, everybody, we've seen everything they have around the spawn area, but I guess I heard that there's a lot more still to see. But, I think we're going to end this episode here because it's getting pretty long, but stay tuned for episode 2, and we will see you guys in a little bit.
Thank you for watching.
Bye. Bye-bye.